In Harlow, you can not only find people whose memories go back to the beginning of the town itself, you can also find the man who designed the town. Sir Frederick Gibberd drew up the master plan for Harlow, and he now lives in the town himself. Sir Frederick, how do you begin to plan something as big and as complex as a town?
Well, you first of all think about what it's all about. It's for people, it's to give them freedom, freedom from the squalor of London in this case. Most people want to live in a two-storey house with a small garden. That means you've got a pretty big, a pretty spread-out town. You've got to get people to be able to conveniently travel around the town, so you've got a problem of transport. And the town itself is on the land. There's landscape here. So you've really got three arts, the arts of architecture, which is building, the arts of road design, and the arts of landscape design. You bring the three together in one overall design, which is called a master plan.
Well, how do you go about planning a town like this without making it look a vast council or a housing estate?
This is, I think, probably the most difficult problem that certainly I had to look at. Most people want their towns to look different. They like to live in their own particular place. How do you get it? Well, I think first of all you look at the land itself. Now here we had a marvellous valley, beautiful hills round, and the buildings are grouped together and they're related to this landscape. Now over my shoulder there you see hills. Now those hills hold the town and separate it from Epping and the whole of the hinterland, and over my shoulder again there's a big landscape wedge which separates one belt of housing from another. And over there, you wouldn't think it, behind the trees there are 20,000 people living. So you've got this marvellous contrast between fairly compact built-up areas and open landscape.
If you had the opportunity to do things again here in Harlow, which would you like to do most?
Well, I'm going to dodge the question to begin with, because I think that, very broadly speaking, I'd do exactly the same thing all over again.
Because, that can't be bad.
Because, you see, people don't change. You see, I've been working here for, 28 years. Well, people haven't changed in that time. And it's still the same land, still the same problem. Now, there are lots of individual things I'd like to see again. I'd like to see a bigger town hall here, but that was nothing to do with me. I'd like to see some better buildings in the town centre.
Sir Frederick, a lot of people said as I've walked about the town, don't think I'm facetious, what about pie and mash? What about jellied eel shops? There's not one in the town and lots of Londoners.
Look, if people want jellied eels and pie and mash, there's no reason why they shouldn't have them. It's nothing to do with the Development Corporation.
Right,
it's demand.
Last question, Sir Frederick. Of all the projects you've worked on, the great cathedral, the great Roman Catholic cathedral at Liverpool, the buildings at Heathrow, which would you like to be most remembered for?
Well, Harlow, of course, because Harlow's really all about people.
Thank you very much, Sir Frederick.